Mr. Chairman, members of the table, honorable ministers, excellencies, dear friends, ladies and gentlemen, I am thanking the government of Brazil for hosting this important event. Dear friends, of over a very 1,000 children in the world today, about 16 of them are child laborers. Half of the total child laborers is in the worst form, and many never go to school. There are 160 million child laborers in the world as per the ILO estimates. Mr. Guy Ryder, Director General of the ILO, in his statement at World Day Against Child Labor, has made a strong appeal for urgent global action to tackle child labor in domestic work. So, how can we stop child labor? There are many different views, ideas, and thoughts in this regard. Among other improving child labor legislation and increasing the quality, relevance, and access to education are more important measures. I believe that without policy coherence, political will, dedication, and commitment of all stakeholders, this problem cannot be addressed effectively. Therefore, I would like to emphasize that this addressing child labor should be linked with the policy programs and projects in relation to education, social protection, social welfare, SIM, and poverty elimination in particular. Now, permit me to share Sri Lanka experience with you all. Child labor in Sri Lanka is low in relative term and to absolute numbers as well. As per the Child Activity Survey 2009, it was 2.5 of the total child population. However, the problem is that 50% of them are in hazardized works. So we are more concerned about the situation, even though it is around 65,000 in absolute numbers, and taking every effort to achieve the promised target of the zero tolerance of the worst form of child labor by 2016. The government of Sri Lanka is committed to eliminate child labor, and his commitment was expressed at the UN World Summit held in 1990 for the protection and development of children. Sri Lanka endorsed the Global Action Plan and ratified UN Convention on Rights of the Child in 1991. We have ratified all ILO conventions, including the 138 and 182 as well. The Constitution of Sri Lanka says the state pledged to promote with special care for the interest of children and youth as to ensure their full development, physical, mentally, moral, religious, and social, and the protection from exploitation and discrimination. Due to the compulsory education in the country up to 14 years of age, there is credible achievement in the accept of school enrollment, literacy, and gender parity. Further, Sri Lanka 10-year Horizon Development Framework 2006-2016, Mahinda Chintana Vision of New Sri Lanka, has specially expressed the need for combating child labor and action that would be taken to formulate border policy to address the issues historically. Accordingly, we have strengthened labor legislation, improved access, quality, and relevance of education. More important, we prepared to Sri Lanka roadmap to eliminate the worst form of child labor by 2016, and initiatives supplemented in the roadmap are being implemented. Dear friends, we will be doing many things. We have thought of the different way to address this issue. Administrative district of Ratnapur, assisted by my ministry, with technical and financial support of the ILO, is embarking on a journey that will make a district free of child labor by June 2016. It's one classic example in this regard. Several creative initiatives bring education, occasional training, welfare program, and poverty elevation program together are being implemented by the district to become a child labor free. Dear friends, we are staged in setting up the child labour free zone, but time does not permit me to share such step with you at this moment. However, finally, what I want to emphasize is that if we are really need to address this issue, well, coordinating effort from policy, strategy, program and project perspective covering the areas of poverty, education, social security, health and occupational very much important and crucial. Ad hoc and individual effort and bring number of registrants along my network. Finally, we appreciate the fullest support and the cooperation of ILO, including IPEC program, extend to us in the effect of eliminating child labour in Sri Lanka. Let me stop now having dream to be realized that all children are going to school free from hunger, vulnerability, and no children at workplace in near future. Thank you.
Obrigado.